Hello everybody. Today's session is session 3 of chapter Human Health and Disease of Biology. So in last class, what did we study was, we had been studying about different forms or different pathogens which causes different types of diseases, and we have come across certain forms of prevention methods. Last class we did start with immunity. I had given just a hint of immunity, where we have studied about two different types of immunity, that is innate immunity and acquired immunity. Innate immunity is got by birth, that is it is inherited from parents, whereas acquired is a learnt form. Okay, in acquired immunity, where if the pathogen attacks our body for the first time, it is termed, or the response to that particular pathogen, that is termed primary response. And if the same pathogen enters into the host body once again, then our body will be having memory cells, based on which one the effect or the attack on those pathogen will be quite more fast compared to the first entry or first response, that is termed secondary response. Secondary response, it is also termed anamnestic response. Secondary response of acquired immunity, it is also termed anamnestic response. So here both the primary and secondary response are based on the production of B and T lymphocytes. When it comes to B lymphocytes, they release army of proteins called antibodies, which fight against the pathogens or antigens entering the host body, whereas T cells assist or helps in production of antibodies in B cells. Next, we had studied about two different forms of acquired immunity, that was humoral immunity as well as cell mediated immunity. Now we'll just have a little bit detail about these two topics. So when it comes to humoral immunity and cell mediated immunity, so when it comes to humoral immunity, it is always mediated by the antibody. So antibody is the one which mediates the action of humoral immunity, whereas cell mediated immunity, it is mediated especially by T cells. So this T is T lymphocytes are the one which mediates the cell mediated acquired form of immunity. Now for example, if you see any patient having a kidney problem or a liver problem or any organ to be transplanted in his body, so there will be two persons, one is donor, one who donates the organ, another one is the recipient. So this donor donates the organ to the recipient. By the time, the recipient body will not be accepting the organs of the donor. Why is that? Means because once the organ or any particular organ given by donor, if it is taken by the recipient body, then it is considered to be a foreign organ. So if it is a foreign organ, what will happen is our immune system will be alert and make sure that foreign substance should be destroyed, and that is the work what will be done by the recipient's immune system. So what happens if the donor donates any organ to the recipient? The recipient's immune system will be rejecting that particular organ because it is considered to be foreign in recipient's body. That is normally happening during the transplant. That is why the transplantation success rate is less. So what can be done is, to recipient, immunosuppressive agent will be given. So this immunosuppressive agent should be taken lifelong by the recipient. What happens if you give this recipient with the immunosuppressive agent? Whenever the transplantation takes place, the immunity of the recipient's body will be nullified, or it will be made inactive, so that the donor's organ is easily transferred into the, or easily transplanted into the recipient. But sometimes, even though immunosuppressive agents are given to the recipient, still the body rejects the organ or the foreign organ. So that is main reason, or for that particular rejection, the main reason is the cell mediated immunity, which is assisted or mediated by the T cells. Even not only for transplant, even for grafting also there will be rejection, that is all controlled by the cell mediated immunity. So that's about humoral immunity as well as cell mediated immunity. Next we have to study, that is about active and passive immunity. First one is active immunity, another is passive immunity. Now when it comes to active immunity, so what is active immunity? Now imagine that this is a host. So if the host body is exposed to different forms of pathogen, so these pathogens will be made sure that these are weakened one or inactive one. These inactive or weakened pathogens are made to attack on the host, so that the host will be able to produce the antibodies against these pathogens. So what is happening in active immunity? We are making the host get exposed to certain types of pathogens. Either it will be injected into the body or through nasal or through aerosols itself, this pathogen will be transferred into the body. Once the pathogen enters into the host will be able to produce this antibody which is against this pathogen or antigen. Remember one thing, antigen and antibodies both have enmity, or they have opposite reaction. Antibody always attack or tries to destroy the antigen. So this antibody production against this pathogen will take some time. It will be initially of low intensity and finally it starts to increase. Once they are successful in destroying the pathogen, automatically this antibodies or the type of antibody to destroy a particular type of pathogen will be stored in the memory cells. So here host is made to get exposed to pathogens, so that in the host body antibodies are produced to destroy this particular pathogen. Initially it is a slow process, but later what happens, the antibody production increases and finally it can recognize the pathogen and store in its memory cells. Once in the memory cells it is stored, if the same pathogen in natural environment if enters into our body, then our body will be pre-prepared or ready with the antibody to destroy that particular pathogen. This is what is called active immunity. It is memory based. Here we are making the host get exposed to different forms of inactive or weakened type of pathogen, so our body produces the antibodies. Once the pathogen is recognized by the body immunity, then the antibodies or what type of antibodies to be produced to destroy this pathogen will be stored in the memory cells. So that's about active immunity. Next is passive immunity. When it comes to passive immunity, here you are injecting the body with ready-made antibody. Here we are not allowing the host to get exposed to the pathogen, or we are not making sure that our body itself produces any antibody. Instead, what we are doing, we are injecting our body with ready-made antibodies. Either it is injected or inherited, or it will be transferred. So for example, if you take colostrum is the first milk produced by the mother, which is compulsified to be fed to the child. Why it is very much compulsified to be fed to the child? Because this colostrum is very much rich in antibodies. So this colostrum, if it is fed to the child from the mother, the antibodies get transferred into the fetus. So colostrum contains large number of antibodies. That is why it should be fed into the child. One more form is through placenta. So through placenta, the mother transfers some of the antibodies when the fetus is within the womb. So through placenta, antibodies get transferred, and through colostrum also antibodies get transferred. So these are examples for passive immunity. When it comes to active immunity is we are making the host get exposed to pathogen to produce the antibodies. Whereas passive, we are directly transferring the ready-made antibodies. This can be done artificially also. Naturally, it will be colostrum, that is the mother's milk, breast milk, which would be fed to the fetus, which is very much rich in antibodies, especially the immunoglobulin A is the antibody which is rich in colostrum, which is transferred into the child, or is through placenta, when the child is in the womb, the mother transfers some of the antibodies into the fetus or the young one. So these both are the examples for passive immunity, that is transfer of ready-made antibody. That is about active as well as passive immunity. Next, we'll discuss about vaccination and immunization. So next is vaccination or vaccine or immunization. When it comes to vaccination, so here vaccines means it is always antidotes or artificially produced antibodies which fight against certain forms of antigen. When it comes to vaccine, what we do or how do we prepare these vaccines? So vaccines prepared will be, now for example, if I take polio as an example, polio will be given to certain aged child, that is below 5 years. What happens is they are given the drops, polio drops will be given. Now what does this polio drops contain? Polio drops contain the virus which causes the polio. So what type of virus is? It is either weakened one or inactive form of virus. So this is either weakened virus or inactive virus will be transferred into the body. Now when this is transferred into the body, what happens if this is the host? Now this antigen is transferred into the host body. Now the host body will produce antibody recognizing it. As it is weak and inactive, it is easy for the host to produce the antibodies because there will be no symptoms produced by this particular pathogen or antigen or microbe. So weakened and inactive forms of antigen or pathogen is transferred into the host body so that they produce the antibody. So even though if the host takes a little bit longer time to produce the antibody, it is of no problem. Why? Because these are inactive or weakened, that is why they do not produce any symptoms in the host. So once the antibodies are ready in the host, they destroy this weakened and inactive forms of pathogen. Now if at all in the natural environment, if the same pathogen in natural condition enters into the body of the host, then we have the antibodies ready in the host. How the antibodies are ready in the host? Because of presence of memory cells. Memory cells involves both B and T cells. So memory cells, B and T cells, what does it do? Once the same pathogen in natural condition, which will not be inactive or weakened, but in natural environment, they will be very much stronger. If the natural environmental virus enters into the same host in which we already have produced antibodies against it, so what happens if they enter, then the memory cells, that is the B cell and the T cell, which have stored in the memory, that is the recognition of this pathogen, what type of antibody to be produced against this particular antigen, what happens, the antibodies will be produced by this B cell and T cell, and they kill the pathogen in natural condition. So what we are doing in case of vaccination, we are artificially injecting the body with the same type of pathogen but in its weakened or inactive form, so that our host or the host body will be producing antibody against that particular type of pathogen. Once our body or the host body is knowing or it recognizes that pathogen, then it will be stored in the memory cell. If the same pathogen under natural conditions, which will not be inactive or which will not be weakened one, which will be very strong and furious, if the same pathogen enters into the body or the host body, what will happen? Their same antibodies will be produced based on the memory cells of B and T cells will be releasing antibodies against the pathogen or antigen to kill them or to destroy them. That is how the vaccination works in our body. So you can take the same example as an example for active immunity. One more example which can be given for passive immunity, that will be tetanus or snake bite. So tetanus or snake bite requires immediate action. You cannot inject the venom into the human body, or less active, inactive, like that. It cannot be injected into the human body because the chances of side effects will be very much high. That is why in case of tetanus or in case of snake bite, if there is tetanus or snake bite, then the action should be immediate. Immediate action means we'll be injecting the host body with ready-made forms of antibodies. Ready-made antibodies will be injected into the body, and we can easily inactivate the venom in case of snake bite. So here in case of tetanus, antitoxin will be introduced into the body, so the action of this tetanus will be reduced. And in case of snake bite, antidote or antibody will be injected, which reduces or nullifies the action of the venom in the body. So that is these both are example for passive immunity in case of vaccination. So that is about vaccination as well as immunization. Nowadays what have happened is recombinant DNA technology, which will be detailedly studying in the chapter biotechnology. Based on this one, they have identified or they have started producing certain forms of antibodies or antigenic production in bacteria or yeast. So example is hepatitis B which, or this can be treated by producing antibody which is produced within the yeast. So this is one of the example using or based on recombinant DNA technology. So that's about vaccination and immunization. Next one will be studying about allergy. Next is allergy. So to define this allergy, allergy is the exaggerated immune response against certain allergens. So now there is one more term I have told, allergens. Allergens means substances which causes allergy. For example, dust. So there might be, it is not common for all. So different people have different forms or different types of allergy, or they get affected to different types of allergy. Maybe in an environment, I might feel sneezing, but some other might not feel the sneeze. So it depends on individual immune system whether you are allergic to that particular pathogen or not. So allergy means it is the exaggerated immune response for any type of allergens. What is allergen? It is the substances which causes allergy, like dust mites, pollen grains, as well as animal dander. Animal dander. So what do you mean by animal dander is, it will be pet hairs. That is, if you have a dog or a cat in your house, if you are allergic to their hairs, then the symptoms can be seen because of this allergens. So allergens, substance which causes allergy. Exaggerated immune response to this particular allergens, that is what is allergy. Now when it comes to allergens, we have told, I have given you different examples. Now what happens, or what is the exaggerated response? We should know the symptoms of the allergy. So the symptoms of allergy will be either sneezing, running nose, watery eyes. In severe cases only, it leads to even breathing problems also. So these are the symptoms of allergies. So allergies are caused, or the symptoms can be seen because of release of certain forms of chemicals by the mast cells. Mast cell is a form of immune cell which releases two different chemicals, that is histamine and serotonin. So during allergy, allergens are responsible for allergy. The symptoms of allergy will be sneezing, running nose, watery eyes, or breathing difficulty. These symptoms are mainly, or it can be seen in a host body, mainly because of mast cells. Mast cells are the type of immune cells which release two different chemicals, that is histamine and serotonin. These two chemicals are released in response to this allergens. Once these two chemicals are released, then our host will start showing certain allergic symptoms. Now, how can you reduce the allergic symptoms? In certain cases, if you go from that particular environment, then automatically the symptoms will be reduced. In severe cases, you have to be treated with either tablets or injections. So what can be done is, you can be, or your body can be given with antihistamine or adrenaline or steroid tablets. By giving these three, your allergic symptoms can be treated or prevented. So mast cells releases histamine and serotonin. To reduce the release of these chemicals, antihistamine, adrenaline or steroid tablets can be given. So that is about this allergy. If you see this allergies, it is largely found in metro cities because of the either lifestyle or pollution. In severe cases, because of this allergy, especially in case of pollen allergies, it will also lead to asthma, that is breathing difficulty in an individual. So that's about allergy. Next one is autoimmunity. Autoimmunity. Autoimmunity, it is memory based. It is memory based acquired form of immunity. Acquired, that is means it is not inherited. Only after the pathogen enters into the body, then only you will be showing the response against, or the immunity will be showing the response against that particular pathogen. That is, it is acquired, memory based. Here it is having the ability to identify self and non-self cells. They have the ability to identify self cells and non-self cells. Self cells means host cells. Non-self means anything which has come from outside. So this is a very important immunity present in our body called autoimmunity, where our body immunity helps in recognizing the self cells and non-self cells and makes sure that only the non-self cells are destroyed, but the self cells are not destroyed and protected. That is about autoimmunity. But due to different, either some unknown reasons or through genetic disorders, this leads to autoimmune disease. Due to genetic disorders, what happens is our body fails to identify the self and non-self cells. So in the course of protecting our body, unknowingly they start destroying the self cells along with the non-self cells. Example for this is a rheumatoid disease. Which is an example for autoimmune disease, where our immune system fails to recognize the self and non-self cells. In the course of protecting the self cells, unknowingly they start destroying the self cells and non-self cells also togetherly. So in together, if you see in autoimmunity, this is a very helpful process in the immune system, where the self and non-self cells will be recognized so that our immune cells destroys only the non-self cells. But due to genetic disorders, what happens? Our autoimmunity will have the disability to identify the self and non-self cells, but in the course of protecting our body, unknowingly along with non-self cells, they destroy the self cells also. So that is about the autoimmunity. So today we have studied about different types of acquired and acquired immunity, where we have come across innate immunity, cell mediated immunity. We have learnt why the transplantation or grafting will be rejected by our body due to cell mediated, especially the T cell immunity or immune cells will be rejecting this particular transplants or grafts. We have come across active immunity, where we are exposing the host body to different forms of pathogen and making sure that the host body produces the antibodies. In the course of destroying this, or the process or initial process is slightly elaborate process, because it have to recognize the pathogen, then produce the antibody. But if the same thing or the same pathogen comes in under natural condition, then our body will be ready with the antibodies, because of the memory cells and B cell and T cell recognizes the pathogen and then destroy them. Passive immunity means we are injecting the body with ready-made antibodies, either injecting or it is transferred from mother to a child. Example is colostrum, that is the first milk given by the mother, which is rich in IgA immunoglobulin, which is transferred into the child or the fetus. Apart from this one, the antibodies can be transferred through placenta from mother to a child. Next is vaccination and immunization we have studied. So in vaccination, you are treating the body with weakened or else if it is inactive pathogen. So this inactive or weakened pathogen will be recognized by the host immunity or immune cells, and they will be producing the antibodies against it. So if the same type of pathogen affects the host in natural condition, then our body B cell and T cell will be ready with their memory cells, plus they will recognize the pathogen and then destroy them. So this can be given as an example for active immunity. One more example you can take under vaccination for passive immunity, that will be for tetanus as well as for snake bite, where the action is required is very much immediate. That is why ready-made antibodies will be injected into the host body, either for tetanus effect or for snake venom which has been entered into the body. So immediate action, that is immediate antibodies, will be acting on the antigen and destroying them, which can be taken as an example for passive immunity. So hepatitis B, where the treatment is done because of the antibodies which are produced within the yeast. Even bacteria is also used for this one, based on recombinant DNA technology. Allergies are the one which is the exaggerated immune response towards certain forms of allergens. These allergens will be either dust in the dust mites or pollen grains or animal skin, that is the dried skin, or the animal hair, that is the animal dander. So for this allergens, our body will be responding by showing certain forms of symptoms. These symptoms will be watery eyes or sneezing or else running nose or breathing problem, because these symptoms are produced because of mast cells. These are the forms of immune cells which releases two different forms of chemicals, that is serotonin and histamine. So serotonin and histamine will be released, and the antigen or this immunoglobulin released when allergy is produced, that will be IgE. Allergy response produces IgE as the antibody or the immunoglobulin. So this histamine and serotonin will be released, and to reduce the effect, either you have to move away from that environment or you should be given with antihistamines, adrenalins or steroid tablets, which reduces the allergic symptoms and gets back your body back to normal. So that is about allergy, and last one is autoimmunity. In case of autoimmunity, it is a form of immune response where our immune cells will be able to recognize the self and non-self cells and tries to destroy only the non-self cells. If there is any genetic disorder, then the immunity fails to recognize the self and non-self cells, and in the course of protecting the body, unknowingly it destroys both the non-self and self cells. Example for this disease or this autoimmune disease is rheumatoid arthritis. So that's about autoimmunity. So next class we'll be learning about immunity or immune organs which are present in our body. Thank you.